Welcome to 2230, your source for comprehensive news coverage. Today, we're diving into a significant announcement made by Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim on Labor Day, the 1st of May. Anwar, also serving as the finance minister, revealed plans for a substantial increase in the salaries of civil servants, sparking conversations across the nation. Anwar's announcement comes as a ray of hope for civil servants, promising a noteworthy increase exceeding 13% in their salaries for the current year. The Malaysian government has earmarked over RM 10 billion, approximately $2.11 billion US dollars, for this purpose, underlining its commitment to ensuring all civil servants benefit from this adjustment. This increase, touted as the highest ever granted to civil servants, marks a significant milestone in Malaysia's labor landscape. Anwar emphasized the historical significance of this wage hike, proclaiming it to be the most substantial raise ever bestowed upon civil servants. He announced that this increase will take effect in December, bringing tangible improvements to the lives of numerous public servants across the country. Furthermore, Anwar highlighted that even the lowest-paid civil servants would experience a significant uplift in their total income, including allowances. He stressed that the minimum monthly income would rise to RM 2,000 from the current RM 1,795, ensuring a more equitable distribution of wealth among government employees. However, Anwar also issued a caveat, emphasizing that this increase is contingent upon expectations of diligence and productivity. He warned that underperforming employees would not receive the reward, underscoring the importance of meritocracy within the civil service. Encouraging parity in the private sector, Anwar urged companies to emulate the government's initiative by fairly distributing profits among workers. He underscored the symbiotic relationship between workers' productivity and company profits, advocating for a more equitable sharing of wealth within corporate structures. In response to Anwar's announcement, Human Resources Minister Stephen Sim Chee Keong voiced his endorsement of the salary hike, deeming it appropriate and reasonable. Minister Sim emphasized the necessity of this adjustment, particularly in light of the stagnant salary structure for frontline workers over the past decade. Acknowledging the diversity of opinions surrounding the government's decision, Minister Sim recognized the inevitability of varying reactions in a democratic society. He underscored the importance of transparent communication to elucidate the rationale behind the salary increase, ensuring that the public understands the government's commitment to rewarding diligent and efficient service. Social media users have drawn attention to a historical precedent, recalling the salary raise announced by 5th Malaysian Prime Minister Abdullah Ahmad Badawi in 2007. This raise ranged from 7.5% to 35% for over a million government employees. In response to these observations, Communications Minister Fahmy Fadzil provided context surrounding the 2007 salary increase. Fahmy clarified that the government's announcement primarily targeted the lowest grade of civil servants, with a 7.5% raise benefiting the highest-ranking officials. Moreover, he emphasized that the percentage mentioned by PM Anwar exceeds the 13% increase announced during the last review of the public service remuneration system in 2012. However, concerns have been raised regarding the timing of the public servant pay increase amidst challenging economic circumstances. There are fears that this hike might exacerbate inflation in the country. Abdul Kadir Jassin, a veteran in Malaysian media, cautiously expressed optimism while extending the benefit of the doubt to PM Anwar regarding the overall impact on the country's economy. Jassin highlighted the potential repercussions of price hikes resulting from increased civil service salaries, citing historical instances where such hikes led to inflationary pressures. He cautioned that without proper regulation, these price hikes could burden non-government individuals and exacerbate economic inequalities. Touching upon the political dimension, Jassin suggested that civil service salary hikes often influence voting behavior in elections. However, he noted that cash incentives alone may not guarantee electoral success, citing examples from past elections to illustrate the complex interplay between economic policies and political outcomes. As Malaysia navigates through these economic challenges, Anwar's announcement heralds a significant milestone for civil servants, promising tangible improvements in their financial well-being. Yet, the government must tread cautiously to mitigate any adverse economic impacts and ensure that this salary increase fosters long-term prosperity for all Malaysians.
欢迎来到 2230, 您全面新闻报道的来源。今天, 我们将深入探讨马来西亚总理安华易卜拉欣在五一劳动节上所做出的重大声明。安华同时也担任财政部长，他透露了一项计划，旨在大幅提高公务员的薪酬，引发了全国范围内的热议。安华的宣布为公务员带来了一线希望，承诺今年他们的薪酬将显著增长超过 13%。 马来西亚政府为此拨款逾100亿林吉特，约合 21.1 亿美元，凸显了政府确保所有公务员受益于此调整的承诺。这一增长被誉为有史以来对公务员给予的最高加薪，标志着马来西亚劳动力市场的重要里程碑。安华强调了这一薪资涨幅的历史意义，宣称这是有史以来对公务员施以的最大涨幅。他宣布，这一增长将于12月生效，为全国数以千计的公务员带来实质性的改善。此外，安华还强调，即使是最低薪酬的公务员也会在总收入中获得显著提升，包括津贴在内。他强调，最低月收入将从目前的1795林吉特上涨到2000林吉特，确保在政府员工中更公平地分配财富。然而，安华也提出了一个警告，强调这一增长取决于勤奋和工作效率的期望。他警告说，表现不佳的员工将不会获得奖励，强调了在公务员队伍中的价值观，鼓励私营部门效仿政府的举措。安华敦促公司公平地分配利润给员工，他强调了员工的生产力与公司利润之间的共生关系，并倡导在公司结构内更公平地分享财富。对于安华的宣布，人力资源部长史蒂文·辛姆志强表示支持薪资涨幅，认为这是应适当和合理的。辛姆部长强调了此举的必要性，特别是考虑到过去十年来一线工作人员薪酬结构的停滞不前。在承认围绕政府决定的多样化意见时，辛姆部长认识到在一个民主社会中，不同的反应是不可避免的。他强调了透明沟通的重要性，以阐明薪资增长背后的理由，确保公众理解政府奖励勤奋和高效服务的承诺。社交媒体用户引起了对一个历史先例的关注，回顾了第五任马来西亚总理阿卜杜拉·阿哈迈德·巴达威在2007年宣布的薪资调整，涉及逾百万政府雇员，涨幅在 7.5% 至 35% 之间。针对这些观察，通讯部长法赫米·法兹尔提供了2007年薪资调整的背景。法赫米澄清说，当时政府的宣布主要针对最低级别的公务员， 7.5% 的涨幅专门惠及最高级别的官员。此外，他强调，安华总理提到的百分比将超过2012年最后一次公共服务报酬制度审查 SSPA 中宣布的 13% 增长。然而，在这些充满挑战的经济环境中，对于公务员加薪时机的担忧已经引起了人们的关注。人们担心这种加薪可能会加剧国内的通货膨胀。马来西亚媒体资深人士阿卜杜勒·卡迪尔假心谨慎地表示乐观，并向安华总理提出了关于公务员加薪对国家经济总体影响的疑虑。假心强调了由于公务员薪资增加而导致的物价上涨可能带来的后果，引用了历史上一些导致通货膨胀压力的情况。他警告称，如果政府不能及时监管价格并防止哄抬物价，这些加薪引起的价格上涨可能会加重非政府个人的负担，并加剧经济不平等。涉及政治层面，贾欣指出，公务员加薪往往会影响选举中的选民行为。然而，他指出，仅靠现金奖励可能不足以确保选举成功，举例说明经济政策与政治结果之间的复杂关系。随着马来西亚在这些经济挑战中前行，安华的宣布为公务员带来了一个重大的里程碑，承诺在他们的财务状况中带来实质性的改善。然而，政府必须谨慎行事，以减轻任何不利的经济影响，并确保这一薪资增长能够促进所有马来西亚人的长期繁荣。